begins with a simple blood draw. From there, medical professionals get platelet-rich plasma that can be used for thickening hair, rejuvenating the face, and a whole lot more.
Yeah, Dr. Meena of Heal and Cure joins us now to share how effective PRP treatments are. Hi, Dr. Meena.
Hello, I'm delighted here to be back here on Daytime Chicago.
Well, let's start about talking about this process. You say it's almost like growing grass.
Yes. Okay, before we get there, first I want to tell you how excited I am today because it's a special day. First, my daughter's turning 21 today.
Congratulations.
And second, I'm talking about hair, which is my favorite thing because I get asked these questions so many times every single day.
Okay.
You know, ponytail is not as thick, mm-hmm. more in the shower, more in the brush, and that's a huge issue, and girls get really, really panicky about
mm-hmm.
it. So I want to, you said spring is there, grass is growing. I want to make you understand with the simple 1, 2, 3 step,
okay.
that worked for me, it worked for my sister, and it has worked for thousands of my patients.
Okay, so how do you start?
So, you know, think about growing hair like growing grass.
Mm-hmm.
You need a seed, you need a good soil, and you need the seed to be able to tap the nutrients from the soil.
Mm-hmm.
Same way, you need a hair follicle, you need a good soil, that means it has all the nutrients, hormones, and vitamins in it,
mm-hmm.
and you should have enough seeds in there. Now, if we talk about them one by one, the macro and micronutrients, that's make sure you have enough protein
mm-hmm.
and enough good fat. Don't be scared of fat. The micronutrients, B vitamins, biotin is a famous one, but you need the iron, you need essential fatty acids.
Mm-hmm.
Hormones. People get stuck on one hormone, never the case. It is how all those hormones, estrogen, progesterone, testosterone, cortisol, thyroid, all of them talking to each other is very important. And when all of this is optimized, the soil is really robust. Then comes the seeds. So don't wait till all the seeds are gone.
Meaning all the hair follicles
right.
are gone. Don't
wait till you see that shiny spot. Once it is thin, that is the best time.
So when should we start? Like
when you feel that when you hold your hair,
uh-huh.
you feel it's not as much as it used to be.
It's full.
That is the best time.
Okay.
Because that means the hair follicles are starting to weaken, the hair is not as strong, and at that time, if you strengthen it up, the results are very, very good.
Okay, so where does the platelet-rich plasma come in?
Yes. So once your blood is optimized, it's simple blood draw, you extract the growth factors, we call them now blood-derived growth factors, and we go use a tiny, tiny needle after numbing, and you go stimulate those hair follicles. It's like nudging them, because sometimes those follicles, they don't tap the nutrients. There's a little sheet which comes in between. So just like you go and aerate your lawn, same way, you go and you do the micro needling for them. I talk about needles and I see the pain, but that's not the reason. You put good, thank God for the good numbing creams. It's numb, doesn't hurt. But once it starts extracting those nutrients, they just start growing on like.
Well, now, does this mean that you can target certain areas?
Yes.
So it doesn't, okay.
You can target the area. Some girls feel that it's thinning on the crown, some back hair, or in general, you can target wherever the area is. But there's a catch in there. You know, I see this all the time. People derive those growth factors without optimizing the blood. Meaning, you come here, my hair is thinning today, I draw the blood and I inject it. No good, because what you drew was no good.
Okay.
First, you have to do some homework, spend the time in optimizing that blood, optimizing the soil, and then when you extract the nutrients and you put them in the right place.
How quickly can you see hair growth?
You see the hair growth within weeks. You know,
really?
By the time your next haircut, 4 weeks, you will feel, my hair is not falling as much, thicker, and by at the end of the second treatment, you should see.
Oh, that's my next question. How many treatments do you need?
You need 3 to 6, depending upon
how spread apart are they?
6 weeks.
Okay.
6 weeks apart.
And how long does the treatment take?
30 minutes.
Oh, okay.
That's not bad.
That's not bad at all.
This is really important because especially as women approach, you know, menopause causes your hair to fall out too.
So,
or being pregnant sometimes.
Yes.
All of that.
PCOS, getting pregnant, postpartum, menopause, perimenopause. Yeah. These are times of huge hormonal fluctuations.
All right. So, Dr. Meena, you need to see her if you're having some issues. Remember, don't wait until it actually falls out. When it starts to thin, that's when you need to see her. You can reach her here if you want more information about platelet-rich plasma. Healing Cure is offering WGN viewers a discount. You can call the number there on your screen to book a consultation, and the first 50 callers can save $200.
Wow.
Dr. Meena, thank you so much. As always, love your energy.
It's always a pleasure to be here.
Thank you.